Hi, and welcome or welcome back to the Big Knit Energy YouTube channel. My name's Sammy, and this is episode 29 of my knitting podcast. If you're new here, that sounds weird to say, but I'm gonna say it anyways. If you're new here, I live in Southern California. I have been knitting for quite a few years. But I just recently got more serious about it. A long time ago, I was not very adventurous with it. And I have started spinning yarn in the last couple months of 2022 and trying out other crafts, which I'll share one with you later. So last year I purchased a lot of yarn, and this year I'm focusing on trying to work through a lot of it. So I'll be sharing stash down videos throughout the year also. And let's just get into it. I have three finished objects. So first one I'll show you guys, I almost forgot about. So last week I had this as a half object, and two weeks ago, and since then I have finished the other one. Here I had started the cuff during the last episode, and this is where I was, and I finished the second one. These are my first pair of DK weight socks, and I knit these on a US 3 double pointed needles, and I used the Crazy Sock Ladies DK vanilla socks as a free pattern, so you can get that off of Ravelry. I knit this in Cornbread and Honey DK weight, which is 75% superwash merino, 25% nylon, and I used, and this is the colorway Holiday Elegance. This was a gift from Witch and Knit and Mama here on YouTube, so go check her out. And I really, really like these. I love the way these colors knit up. And I just like the way these socks look, and I'm going to wear them now. I was waiting to wear them. My next finished object is blocked, but it does not have ends woven in because I'm lazy. And this is a sweater I designed. This is affectionately known as the Cypher sweater. And I knit this in Knit Picks palette. It's 5 different colors, but only doing 2 color work. And a circular yoke. Baggy fit for the way I knit it, at least. This is knit in, I can tell you guys the colors, I guess. Maybe not. I don't know where I put the labels. Anyways, I think this top green is Shower Heather. This light green is Spearmint. This dark green is Douglas fir, maybe something fir, I think. This gray, I don't remember what the gray was, oyster heather maybe, and then the purple indigo heather, I don't know for sure. If you guys want to know, I will check, but until then, I don't know. So I'm going to post some finished object photos of me wearing this on Instagram, probably. I'm better at posting finished objects on Instagram than Ravelry. But yeah, I really like the way this worked up. It's super comfy, super lightweight, actually. I used one ball of all the colors except the gray. I didn't even make it through one of those, and then I broke into the second ball for the other colors. But I'm really happy to be done with this. It took me a long time. I stopped working on it, and it took me a while to pick it back up. But I'm gonna weave in the ends and wear it. So my next finished object has ends woven in, and I actually wore this today. This is my Alpenglow, and I'm really happy I have this done, and I really like the fit. I did not do very many modifications, and I will tell you about them. So this is knit in Mace of Skeins Club Base in the colorway Cupid, not Moonglow, The Wandering Flock Merino Fingering Singles in the colorway Icy Lavender, Spin Cycle X Magpie Dyed in the Skein in the colorway Cinder, and Spin Cycle Dyed in the Wool in the colorway Love Spell. And the only modification I did was on the sleeves. I only did like 2 decreases and they're down here. And then once I got into the pink, I did a couple rapid decreases because I just don't like tight sleeves. And I sized up on the sleeve needles. I didn't manage my yarn at all because I don't care if the colors like match up. So, and I'm really happy with the way it turned out. It's super comfy. I don't want to change anything about it. I just really like it. I'm glad to have it off the needles because for some reason those 2 sweaters just like sat without getting a lot of attention for quite a while. So it feels good to have them not hanging over my head anymore. I do have a spinning finish object, so I guess I'll show you that before I move on to whips. So this is my finished spin. I don't think I counted how many yards this is, but this is a 2-ply. I spun this from Rolags. It was my first time spinning from Rolags. And this fiber is from the Woolly Witch. And I believe it's merino. I think it was merino bamboo and not Stellina. This sparkle has a different name. I don't remember, but yeah, it's from the Woolly Witch on Etsy and it's just absolutely stunning. I'm obsessed with it. Each yarn I spin, I'm like, how can I love you this much? But I do. So yeah, there's that. It's called like Stardust or Angelina or Firestar or something like that. So that's my finished spin. I have 1 new cast on and 1 existing whip. So I'll show you guys the existing whip first. This is my Habitation Throw that I am knitting with the Super Glow Fibers 12-Day Cosmic Dust Advent. And here it is so far. This little Bulbasaurus Rex is where I was last time. So this didn't get a lot of love. I was really focusing on finishing up those 2 sweaters, but I did work on this a little bit. And now that I have 2 sweaters out of the way, maybe I'll work on this more, maybe not. But I don't know if you guys were here for Vlogmas, but I was opening up the Typical Bliss 12-Day Advent, and this was one of the notions. And I had no idea what it was, but you just keep going down. So like I just finished the 3rd row, so I'll slip the 4th ring on there next. So it's a 10 row counter, which is perfect because this has a 10 row repeat. Having a hard time saying things. This is in a Republica Unicornia. Sorry. A Republica Unicornia bag. And she dyed this fabric. And my next whip is spilling. So my next whip is the Fisher Quine jumper, and it is a cabled raglan, which you can't see my cables super well because of my color choice and my yarn choice. So I'm knitting this in Mace of Skeins yarn. Let me grab the labels. All right, so I'm knitting this in Maysip Skeins High Roller DK, which is 80% superwash, 10% cashmere, 10% nylon, and this the color Pumpkin Spice. And then I'm holding with that Maysip Skeins Full House Base, which is a 74% baby surrey alpaca, 26% silk, and the colorway Roasted Pumpkin. So these were stash yarns, so that's good. And I really, really love it. I could have more defined cables if I were using a thicker yarn and not fluffy yarn and not such a variegated yarn, but I don't care. So this is it. I have already separated sleeves, but just barely, and then knit a few rounds on the body. So this is going really fast. I started this less than a week ago, and I really like it so far. I do think that blocking might help define these honeycomb cables a little bit, but I'm not really worried about it. I like the way the texture looks. Oh, but one thing about the Fisher Klein jumper, which I found very interesting, is it wants you to knit the main fabric with a 7mm, which I thought, no problem. I definitely have that in my sets, because I have smaller than that and larger than that. And for some reason, even if you're going half sizes, like a US 10 and a half is a 6.5mm, a US 10 is a 6mm. Makes sense. A US 11 is an 8mm. Why does a half size all of a sudden jump 1.5mm? Like, that's not cool. Anyways, so I don't have the right size. So I sized down needles, which was probably a good thing since I'm using a thinner yarn, but very weird. I don't agree with that decision. So whoever's behind that, why? Next, I have my last whip and it's a new craft. So today I went and took a weaving class at my local yarn shop, and you get to take home the loom for a week. So I am weaving a scarf. Here it is. It looks like it got messed up in the car actually, which is sad. It's okay though. But this is, actually it's bugging me, it's not that okay. This is in the Barocco Sesame yarn. So I think it's an acrylic wool something blend. And I showed you guys this yarn in last week's episode. I'm ready to join some more. So I will have a finished scarf to show you guys next time. So here it is, and I'm really enjoying it so far. All right, everything else I have is an acquisition, so we're just gonna get into that. I did do good and not buy any more yarn, but I have been buying fiber. I don't know if that's just as bad or not, but I bought some more of that fawn colored Jacob wool from Skagit Woolen Works. I showed you guys that in the last episode also, and I just decided I can spin this and either have a nice neutral sweater's quantity of yarn, or I can even dye it. And it'll be nice and cool to dye over this color. So now I have 4 of these. So 4 4-ounce balls of roving. So 16 ounces. So I'm excited to spin that. Basically like having 4 skeins in yarn. Here's the one I already had. Toss it in that box. And then, what else did I buy? I also bought some fabric from Blackbird Fabrics. I've bought fabric from them before. This is a viscose linen slub. So it's 65% viscose, 35% linen. I like viscose linen blends. I don't know why. I just do. So I bought this in the color lilac. What I really wanted was this viscose linen noil, which is 70% viscose, 30% linen. I wanted this in the color wisteria, which I have a little swatch of, but they didn't have it for some reason, so I got a different purple. And I'm just hoping to make some like summer dresses or something out of these. This is the viscose linen noil in the colorway sage, because I really like to wear my knitted sweaters and tops over dresses. I wore a no frills over a like really plain dress that I sewed last weekend, and I just felt really good in it, so I wanted to be able to make some more. So there's that. And then with a gift card I got for Christmas, I bought hand carders. So these are Ashford hand carders. I just got like the regular ones. So there they are. I put the little handles on right before I started filming. And I got these from Paradise Fibers. And I got some little rainbow mohair locks. Mohair locks? Maybe they're just fiber locks. I don't know. This is from Compass Moon Creations. So, yeah. Let me open this because I've never touched locks of wool before. Okay. They feel like exactly what they look like. They're not that soft. They're not itchy, they're just not soft. Weird. Either way, I'm excited to have them. Excited to make some Rolex or something. So basically why I got those carders is because I want to be able to use all my scraps from spinning and make Rolex so I can spin them. Yeah, I guess that's it. I got this from Blackbird Fabrics also. These are some buttons. They're 20 millimeter something buttons. Oh, from Pigeon Wishes. There's 10 of them. And I just thought they were interesting. So, yeah. I also got these just little plain tags so that I can label my yarn that I spin, because I haven't had any way to do it, and then I have to keep recounting how much yardage it is. So now I'll be able to keep notes of the fiber content, how I spun it, and I put that in my journal also, but still, and what the yardage is, so that I can just glance them quickly. And that's it for acquisitions. So I guess that's all I have for you guys right now. It felt like a good week, like I got a lot done, and I'm excited to have more to show you guys next time. Probably gonna have a couple random videos go up, and I expect next week to have a stash down update. I've been logging what I've been using, so I don't know if I should add stash down into my podcast episodes or if I should make it its own video. So you guys let me know down below, and I'll see you next time.